Hello students, myself Jyoti Razdan. Today we will study about matrices. So when I am talking about matrices, the first question comes to your mind, what are matrices and why should we learn matrices? So matrices are used in computers, they are used to make the electronic spreadsheets, they are used for computation of data, etc. and most important, which you have already done in previous classes, solving the linear equations also. So you can solve the equations using matrices. You all are seeing your report cards since your childhood. The report cards which you get at the end of your session. So if you want to see the marks scored by you in physics in second term or in first term, so what will you do? You will see your subject here, so the subject physics, and you will go here and you will see your marks in the first term and the second term. You can see, like, same way you can check the marks of any of the subject. So you can see this arrangement. This arrangement is a matrix. So this is matrix. So what is a matrix which we are going to study? It is the rectangular arrangement of objects which we call elements. So here you can see you have rows, that means horizontal lines are called rows and vertical lines are called columns. So in matrices you have the symbol for, we write the data in this form. This is a matrix where you have the rows and you have columns. Okay, so when we write the element, so where we write the elements, if I write the element 1, so that means this element, it lies in which row? This is row 1, this is row 2, and this is row 3. Similarly, this is first column, second column, and third column. I will write the element here as A11. That means if you see, this is the element in the first row and in the first column. Similarly, I can write this element as A12. What does it mean? It means this is an element in the first row and in the second column. Now you come to this place, what will you get? This is the element in the first row and third column. So observe it, A11, first row, first column, first row, second column, first row, third column. So I can repeat it. Now I can write any element here also. So I can see this element, where it lies. It lies in second row and second column. So I will write it as A22. That means in general I can write any element by Aij. What does I represent? I represent row and J represent column. And the element is denoted by, any element of the matrix is denoted by Aij, where I represent the row and J represent the column. If I write this element, so this 3 represent the row and the second one represent the column. So this is, and the matrices are denoted by, always we denote the matrices by capital letters, like this is A. And the element we write as Aij. Now, we can see how many rows are there. There are 3 rows and 3 columns. If I write all the elements, this can be A21, A23. Then I can complete this matrix A31, A32 and so on. Now, it has 3 rows and 3 columns. And we can check how many elements are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That means 3 rows and 3 columns. So 3 multiplied by 3 gives you 9. That means this. Now we can define the order of the matrix. Order is defined by row into column. It means if you are having a matrix A, and I have told you that element is denoted by Aij, so A can be written as Aij, and what is the order of this matrix? 3 by 3. So order of the matrix is number of rows into number of columns. The number of rows it is having and number of columns it is having. So in general, we can take the order as M into N. If I am saying A is a matrix of order M by N, what does it mean? It means it has M rows and N columns. Now how to, this is about now, we can construct the matrices of different orders. If I have to write, if this is the order of the matrix, if I write a matrix you can see how many rows it has. It has 3 rows, R1, R2 and R3. And how many columns it has? It has only 1 column. That means if in any matrix you have n rows and only if you are having only 1 column, it is called a column matrix. So what is a column matrix? A column matrix is a matrix which is having only 1 column. So in general, we can write the order of the column matrix as you can have n number of rows and only 1 column. So you can write it as n into 1. So if any matrix is given whose order is n into 1, you can immediately say that it is a column matrix. Now, if you have, I will write another matrix. B is a matrix having these elements A, B, C. Now, how many rows it has? It has only 1 row. And you can see how many columns? C1, C2 and C3. The matrix which is having only 1 row is called a row matrix. A row matrix can have n number of columns. So in general, we can write the order of a row matrix by 1 into n. So if you are, somebody asks you, what is a, if you are given a matrix of order 3 by 1, what will be it? It is having 3 rows and 1 column, so it will be a column matrix. If you have 1 by 5, so it is having only 1 row and 5 columns, so it will be a row matrix. So now you know about the order of the matrix and you know about the elements of the matrix. Now let's construct a matrix. If you want to construct a matrix A, you have to construct a matrix of order 2 by 3 and it is given that element is given by Aij is given by I plus j by 2. The first thing is you have to construct a matrix of order 2 by 3. What does it mean? It means it has how many rows? It has 2 rows and 3 columns. So I will write it like this. 2 rows, horizontal lines are called rows and vertical lines are columns.
So you will have A 1 1, A 1 2, A 1 3, and the second one will be A 2 1, A 2 2, and A 2 3. Now the formula to write the elements is given by I plus J by 2. So what I have to do, what is the value of I here and what is the value of J here? You have to write the values of I and J from here in this formula and we will find the elements of the matrix. So this is the element A11. So 1 plus 1 by 2. This will be A11. Now A12 will be 1 plus 2 by 2. Similarly, the third one, 1 plus 3 by 2. Now A21, 2 plus 1 by 2. A22, again 2 plus 2 by 2. And this is A23, 2 plus 3 by 2. So now we can simplify and write the elements of the matrix. So 1 plus 1 by 2, 2 by 2, 1, 3 by 2, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 by 2, 2, 3 by 2, then 2 plus 2, 4 by 2 is 2, and this will be 5 by 2. So that means now you have constructed a matrix of order 2 by 3 and the elements are given like this. This is how we will construct the matrix of given order. Now the question arises, if I have told you, you can find the number of elements of a matrix by its order. If you have, this is a matrix of order 2 by 3. So that means how many elements you should have? 2 into 3, 6. So you can count, you are having 6 elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, if you are given the number of elements, you can easily construct the matrices. Like, I'll give you example. If the number of elements in a matrix is 12. So what can be the possible orders? The first thing is, for our number of elements 12, so the same way you are writing the factors of 12, the same way you can write the order of the matrix. 1 by 12, so you can have a matrix of order 1 by 12. You can have a matrix 12 by 1. You can easily see 1 into 12, row into column, one row, row matrix. Another one, 12 rows, one column, column matrix. That means you can have one row matrix, you can have one column matrix. Now, 12 can be also written as 2 into 6 or 6 into 2. That means the element, the matrix which is having the order 2 by 6 will also have 12 elements. The element with the matrix which is having order 6 by 2 will also have 12 elements. Same way, what are the other factors? The other factors can be written like 3 into 4 and 4 into 3. And is there any factor? No. So how many possible orders are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you will have 6 different matrices. But all the matrices will have same number of elements, which is 12. Now, if a matrix is having 5 elements, what are the possible orders it can have? It will have, because you know that 5 is a prime number, so it will have only 2 factors, 1 and itself. So 1 into 5 and 5 into 1. So which type, 2 type of matrices you will have if the number of elements is prime? So you will have 2 orders, different orders. You will have 2 matrices, one is a row matrix and one is a column matrix. This is about the order of a matrix, I think by now you are clear with the order of the matrix. Now next come, what is a zero matrix? Zero matrix or null matrix. Zero matrix is a matrix whose all the elements are zeros. This is a zero matrix. This is a zero matrix of order 2 by 2. Now, you can see this matrix is having same number of rows and same number of columns. So, any matrix which is having same number of rows and columns, that matrix is called a square matrix. So, this matrix is a square matrix as well as zero matrix. So, two things we can see here, all the elements are zero and this is a, so what is a square matrix? A square matrix is a matrix which has same number of rows and column, so then the order will be 2 by 2. That means it has 2 rows and 2 columns. Now after that, after zero matrix, you have now diagonal matrix. I will write a matrix. Diagonal matrix. So first thing is, what is the diagonal of a matrix? Diagonal of a matrix is a matrix where the elements are of the form AII. That means if you have this element, this will be A11, this will be A22, and this will be A33. Now you can ask, so why this is not the diagonal? This is also a diagonal, but we don't consider it as a diagonal of the matrix, because we define the diagonal of a matrix by AII. That means the value of I and J is same. As you know, that element is denoted by AIJ. So what is the elements in the main diagonal? Elements of the main diagonal are the elements where I is equal to J. You can see in all the elements, I is equal to J. So this is the diagonal of a matrix. Now the diagonal matrix is a matrix which has all non-zero elements in the main diagonal, in the diagonal, and rest all the elements are zeros. You can see that means A11 is 1, A12 is 0, A13 is 0. Similarly, all the elements are 0. Only the elements in the main diagonal are non-zero. So we can define the diagonal matrix as Aij is not equal to 0 for I equal to J, and rest Aij is equal to 0 for I not equal to J. Wherever you see I is not equal to J, you will find that element as 0. You can see this element is 1, 2. That means I is not equal to J, so it is 0. So you can see this element is non-zero. You can see I is equal to J. So this is the diagonal matrix. After diagonal matrix, we have a scalar matrix. Next comes the scalar matrix. Scalar matrix. Now, all of you know what is a diagonal matrix. Diagonal, what is the difference between a scalar matrix? There is a simple difference between the two matrices. Rest, all the things are zero. Here, you can see all the three elements are different. You are having here 1, 2, and 3. All the elements are different. But in a scalar matrix, all the diagonal elements are same. You can have this as 2, 2, 2. Rest, all the elements are zeros. this is a scalar matrix, or you can define the scalar matrix. It is not necessary that it has to be 2. It can be any constant. It can be k, it can be minus 1, it can be root 2, it can be any number. But one thing you have to keep in mind, all the elements will have the same value. So we write it as the same way we have defined for diagonal matrix. We will write Aij is when Aij is not equal to Aij is equal to k for I equal to j. That means k is any scalar. That is why it is called a scalar matrix. It can take any value. So it can take, so if you are giving value root 2 to k, so what will you get? So you will have root 2, root 2, root 2 here. All the three elements will be root 2. If you are giving value k, you are giving value minus root 3. So the all the elements will be here minus root 3, minus root 3, minus root 3. Rest all the elements will be 0. So this was a scalar. So now it is very important to differentiate between these two matrices, diagonal matrix, scalar matrix. And then the third comes identity matrix, very important matrix. Identity matrix is denoted by I, and what you have in the identity matrix, the word itself, you all of you know that what is identity? Identity is 1. So you will have elements in the main diagonal are having the value 1. Rest all the elements are 0. So what will you write? Aij equals to 1 for I equal to j, and Aij is equal to 0 for I not equal to j. This is the identity matrix. And now you can see the order of all the three matrices is same. This is 3. So for first thing for the diagonal matrix is it has to be a square matrix. The diagonal matrix, scalar matrix, and because the diagonals you can find in the square matrices only. You cannot find, if I write a matrix of order 2 by 3, so if you have, here I will write. You cannot have a diagonal here. So that is why it is important for the diagonal matrix, the first condition is it is a square matrix. So I'll repeat the difference between the three. The diagonal matrix is a matrix where the elements in the main diagonal are non-zero elements, rest all the elements are zeros. Then the scalar matrix where the elements in the main diagonals are the scalars, rest all the elements are 0. And the third one is the identity matrix where the elements in the diagonal are unity, rest all the elements are zeros. Now after this we will study the equality of matrices. The two matrices are said to be equal if they have same order. These are the two matrices. You can see the elements are entirely different, but they are having the same order. The order of this matrix is, you can see how many rows are there? 1, 2, 2 rows and 3 columns. So it is 2 by 3. And this is also 2 by 3. So the two matrices are equal if they are having the same order. Now, if the matrices are equal, it means their corresponding elements are also equal, which will give you the values of A, B, C, D, E, and F. So you just check what is the corresponding element. 1 is the corresponding element to A. That means A is equal to 1. B is equal to 2, C equals to 3, D equals to 4, E equals to 5 and F is equal to 6. Now you can, using the equality of the matrices, you can find the unknown values. If you are given two matrices, using the matrices you can see, you can find the values of X and Y from this equation. Like X plus Y is equal to 0, you can find, you can see this element is equal to this element. So X plus Y equal to 0, you can find the value of X. So you should, actually you should, you can have for different variables also, Z plus W, Z minus 3W. So X plus Y will be equal to 0 and X minus Y equals to 1. So you can solve it. You have already done X plus Y 0, X minus, you can solve them by adding the 2. You will get 2X equal to 1 and X is equal to 1 by 2. Similarly, you can find the values of Y, Z, W, etc. Torvo vantai fikri ki kya chu matrices asan, what kya chu zero matrix, kya chu diagonal matrix, kya chu identity matrix, kitkan hakovas matrix jo hai equate karethan. Thank you.
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें, अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं, क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।